Hello, I'm Darla, the youngest daughter of Patricia Ann Rains. A beloved lady, we are virtually gathered here to celebrate today. I am very grateful that God chose her to be my mother and friend. Keith and I are so blessed to have had the privilege of lovingly protect, enjoy, and nurture her as she did for me all the years prior. The challenges and trials were worth every minute to grow into this position, as it didn't always come naturally. God moved in us in a mighty way. Thank you for your support and love as we gave her the absolute best care possible to keep her at home. Listen as her beautiful story is revealed.
How do you know when someone lives their life by the Spirit? Well, in the Bible, Paul, a devout follower of Jesus, says in the book of Galatians that if someone truly knows Jesus and lives a life in the freedom he gives, that person doesn't indulge their flesh with worldly pleasures, but rather serves others humbly in love. Many of you watching this video have known Patricia Rains for a lot longer than I have. And you've seen this humble and sacrificial love displayed in many different ways through her words and actions. There's no doubt that Grandma Pat lived by the Spirit. Now to you, Pat may be a relative, mom, a dear friend, even great-grandma. Or for me, and quite a few others, simply as Grandma Pat. Now, ever since I married into the family 8 years ago, Grandma Pat has just always been there. She's always been there to give you a smile, always there to exemplify what Paul goes on to describe the fruits of the Spirit. Now, I'm going to read this list of fruits that Paul describes here. And as I do, I'm going to read it a little slowly. Because while I read, I would like for you to think back on your years with Grandma Pat and consider all of the ways that she embodied these fruits in her life. So Galatians 5:22 says, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and ice cream." Okay, so that last one wasn't really in there. But if ice cream were a fruit of the Spirit, it would shine through Grandma Pat as bright as any other. And though I have seen self-control in the Rains family, the real last fruit of the Spirit here, self-control, I can't say I've ever seen that fruit when there's almond joy around. Now, Paul finishes this section about living a life by the Spirit by urging his readers not to become conceited, provoking, or being jealous of one another, but rather to keep in step with the Spirit. So for the remainder of this online service, let's be reminded of these fruits that Grandma Pat exemplified so well, as many stories, photos, songs, and memories of her are shared. And let's allow Grandma Pat to be a great example of how to live a life by the Spirit.
I have had this story welling up inside of me for over a year. I will passionately share how God radiated His light through our loving mother, grandmother, and friend to deeply love and influence everyone she met with her gentle yet adventurous spirit. 1 Corinthians tells us love is patient, kind, never gives up, is not selfish, and always looks for the best in others. Pat, Mom, Grandma left us a legacy of loving well in her family, friends, home, animals, and nature. She loved life and pursued it with passion. She was born September 2nd, 1928, to Harold Franklin Sweeney and Mildred, we called her Munker, McCluskey Sweeney, who met each other at Yellowstone National Park. As an only child, she spent much of her childhood running the neighborhood with Evelyn Lester, cooking up mischief wherever they could, flying cross-country with her father in his co-owned single-engine plane might have contributed to her entering Purdue's aeronautical engineering program and meeting her future husband, Donald Keith Raines, a World War II B-29 pilot, farm boy, and noted fast-pitch softball player. With her MRS degree in hand, they went on a honeymoon to the East Coast and lived for 2 years in an Airstream trailer at Purdue. Then they moved to Frankfort, Indiana, and had Mark in October of 1951. They rented a small house and soon met Doris and Amos, beginning a pattern of seeking close neighbor relations. 5 years later, they built the Antioch Ranch House, designed by Mom, and moved in with Mark, Mike, and Donna. Dina and Darla coming along soon after. This is where the magic begins. Being an only child left her little experience with family life and managing a home. Yet with an abundance of love and perseverance, she developed many skills to pass on to her children, and then their children. We'll start with her passion for family, cuddling babies, playing with toddlers, investigating with 5-year-olds, exploring with teenagers, and phone calls and care packages sent to college students. She now has 16 grandchildren and 24 and a half great-grandchildren, influenced by her talents. She instilled confidence in the ability to fix anything, make anything, conquer anything, no limits, no boundaries. She encouraged free play and imagination, created a healthy environment and love for exploration. Although with her spunk, she had a quiet, gentle, sweet spirit and overflowed with forgiveness and peacemaking. Exemplifying strong character, we grew up knowing right from wrong, how to work hard and use money wisely. She was thrifty, practical, and enterprising. She equipped us to become individuals and independent thinkers and insisted we excel in school. All offspring combined, we have 18 college degrees, 10 masters, and 3 doctorates. Talk about a positive influencer. Keith, Darla, and Kristen followed their footsteps by meeting their spouses while attending Purdue. Boiler up! Holidays were very special at our home, with decorations, traditional foods, caroling parties with prairie singers and Purdue Glee Clubbers. Family coming together. Beds stuck everywhere, even some in tents in the backyard. She created family traditions. Church Sunday mornings. Antioch Church Bible School. Blueberry and strawberry picking. Travelogues and orchard visits. Disney movies on Sunday night with popcorn and milkshakes. Homemade ice cream, the crank kind, and back rubs, of course. Mom loved all seasons. Flower bulbs in the spring, swimming in the summer, crunchy leaves in the fall, snowshoeing, sledding, skiing, and anatomically correct snow women in the winter. Our backyard was outdoor heaven with jungle gyms built by Dad, sandbox, dirt pile, pools, swings, climbing trees, basketball, stilts on tin cans, croquet, badminton, zip line, and of course spending many nights in the shack. Even into her adulthood, it wouldn't be unusual to find her sleeping on a cot on the back porch. Her audacious attitude from her mother, no doubt, took her up in the air in several forms. She logged many flight hours until after her father stopped paying for lessons. Darla's son Jason just earned his pilot's license. We collect her courage and bravery to go rally cross racing, Dina's family, zip lining, whitewater rafting for Darla and Sam, and even kayaking over falls. Her nurturing, loving side, undoubtedly from her father, prompted us to be family-focused, stay-at-home moms, and has manifested in future generations.
Yummy. Ooh. Sharing germs.
It's silly.
Mm-hmm. Got our fire going.
It is very important to take care of each other. And no matter how old, and no matter how hard. Mark's son Gabe is a masseuse. Darla's daughter Kelly majored in Christian counseling. And Julia, in progress, and Mark earning PhDs in psychology. Mom is very appreciative of cards, calls, and coffee visits on her front porch, her happy place. She excelled in the art of baking. Although we joke her pies wouldn't win any beauty contests, they sure did taste delicious, which has passed down through the generations. She would make the best cinnamon rolls, oatmeal, homemade noodles, brownies from scratch, dinner rolls, French bread for the Latin Club, loaded chocolate chip cookies, and homemade pizza. Dina is now known for her famous cookies and delicious breads. Mark's son Gabe and his wife Carrie even began a mouth-watering baking business called Rains, Grains, and Sweets. Mike's son Teo developed his own recipes to become an award-winning brewmaster, crafting specialty beverages and founding Edelbrow Brewing Company. Mom's essence is threaded through every fabric of our beings. Creativity abound. She loved sewing dolls, costumes, dresses, pajamas, making finger puppets, and most of all, quilting. This encouraged me to create 8 dinosaur costumes with no pattern and a soccer ball boy. Julia and Dina carry on to stitch beautiful quilts.
Hi, Grandma. It's your granddaughter, Anna. And I'm just reminiscing on all of the wonderful times that we've had at your house for Christmas, Thanksgiving, summers. You always had such warm hospitality. Everything was always so beautiful, and I have such fond memories. When I was really young, I don't remember what age, but I remember getting Susie, my Susie doll, for the first time, and you made this. Do you remember? You made this doll. And I played with her for many, many years. She still is my favorite doll, always was my favorite doll. And I named her Susie. Yes, and whenever I see her, she reminds me of you and how talented you are sewing and your great love for your children and your grandchildren. And I hope that one day I can have as much love for all the people around me as you have always had for us. I love you, Grandma. Hope to see you soon. Hugs and kisses. Bye.
She was resourceful and ingenious with furniture restoration. We always had an art table to promote drawing, coloring, and painting. Mom had an eye for color and became a talented nature artist. Seeing Mom's oil paintings gave me the courage to paint and capture adventures on canvas. I am certain this creativity is being instilled in future generations. Mom loved to read books to children, instilling a love of books. This produced an English teacher, Mike, and Dina's daughters, Jennifer and Rachel, majoring in English, with Rachel getting a doctorate in English literature and is currently an assistant professor at Marion College. To expand and enrich growing experiences and build confidence, she encouraged joining clubs, variety show and theater productions. She loved performing arts of all kinds. Donna and Mike performed in Arsenic and Old Lace. And we were all in multiple variety shows at Clinton Prairie. And Mike was in several Red Barn plays. Although her mother was a concert pianist who taught piano lessons, Mom didn't linger long playing saxophone, but passed on the love of music to generations. Music transported her, moved her. She frequented concerts and bluegrass festivals. Mom loved when Cindy, Rachel, and Matt visited with their guitars. She did insist on us taking piano lessons and enjoyed many a jam session. Mark, with the Marijuana Brass, is now in a contraband in Maine. Dina followed him with trombone and serenaded us with John Denver songs by the campfire. Darla got her trumpet out to encourage the homeschool band and ended up playing 15 years in her church orchestra. Mike has a music studio in his basement, and his son Casey followed along playing jazz trumpet. Donna's family took music genetics the farthest. Jonathan sang in the award-winning North Star Boys Choir. Tasha has an advanced degree from Peabody Conservatory in viola and violin. Anna was a member of the symphony orchestras with violin, and Becca arranged and performed choir and orchestra performances for Patrick Henry College. And Julia, a vocalist and pianist, is earning her doctorate in music performance psychology. The music accomplishments will be personally arranged and played by Cindy Smith, a close friend, on guitar, Matt and Rachel Bristow, grandchildren, on guitar, and Joseph Hogan, 6-year-old pianist, a great-grandson, and composed his own songs, followed by a special arrangement recorded by Donna's children from all different states. Many of Pat's lifelong friendships grew from softball games, church activities, and through her kids' social groups. She made friends everywhere she went and taught us that community matters. Pat was a sought-after neighborhood friend to many, a living lesson of love, generosity, and hospitality. Her loving home hosted church, picnic, ice cream socials, many, 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 many birthday parties, many game-centered gatherings, and even foreign exchange students. As food was always abundant, no one ever left hungry, not even the birds. Mom had a green thumb and used gardening as therapy. Remember the bushel baskets of corn and green beans? Our pantry was filled with canned green beans, bread and butter pickles, crab apple jelly, frozen blueberries, corn, strawberries, raspberries, rhubarb, and asparagus. Nutrition was very important to Mom as she made family meals from scratch, complete with meats, fruits, and vegetables. Always wheat bread and very little sugar. With Dad being a Hall of Fame softball pitching legend, we grew up at the Ball Diamond and Park Pool. Mom could float for hours on end. Combined with an active lifestyle, it is no wonder she and Dad produced excellent athletes whose records are still on the Clinton Prairie record board. She cheered for innumerable sporting events, never missed a single one. Mark became a force to be reckoned with as a linebacker, and Mike was a very quick quarterback. We all excelled in track. Dina took it the farthest by playing volleyball at Hanover and Earlham Colleges. Darla's son Jason is outstanding in volleyball and still plays in leagues. Donna's daughter, Anna.
Go!
Swimming lessons were insisted upon, with all five becoming lifeguard certified. Donna currently teaches swimming lessons and works magic with children. And the rains came. Frankfort, Indiana. Her vivacious love for the outdoors prompted us to camp and hike often in Indiana's spectacular state parks, and to execute cross-country tent trailer camping trips through national parks in the U.S. We were allowed only what would fit into our dilly duffel bags, but could collect special treasures. We would make woodland stores, swing on vines, and build lean-tos. The infamous travel goodie bag, vinyl window stick-ons, and car games kept us quiet. Her campfire girl experience in her youth catapulted her into being a den leader for Cub Scouts and troop leader for Brownies and Girl Scouts. Remember the cases upon cases of Girl Scout cookies in our family room? This led to Mark and Mike becoming Eagles, Donna and I marrying Eagle Scouts, and our boys becoming Eagle Scouts. I was a den mother for 4 years and Keith was scoutmaster. Then Keith and I formed Co-Ed Boy Scout Venture Crew 007 to guide and influence young lives and continue the prophecy, if you take your kids to state parks, they will take their kids to state parks. This completes our 20th year. Her love of the woods and water, swimming, canoeing, sailing, and fishing, taught by Uncle Bill and Aunt Renee, prompted Pat and Don to build a Northwoods cabin retreat in Wisconsin on Bird Lake in 1980. Donna and Richard got married there. After her husband's death in 1987, Pat's persevering spirit led her to her cabin, home away from home, multiple times a year. Beloved collies in tow. It is no surprise she made lifetime friends all around the lake. She entertained three generations of children there who have come to share her love of the lake and the local ice cream. Ice cream, as it clearly solves everything, is an imperative part of our childhood/adulthood. Dairy Queen after canoeing for root beer floats. Milky Way after swimming. Well, you get the pattern. We are on a first name basis with Patty at Charlie Cheese Ice Cream Parlor. We are doing our part to pass it on to the next generation. Here's to you, Grandma. Mom passed down her avid love of animals, dogs especially. Collies were her constant companions, with cats holding a top second. I would tease her that her collies were needle noses, and she fired back that retrievers were blockheads. She would remind you to try to be the person your dog thinks you are. Clearman girls won top awards in 4-H dog obedience training, and Julia is currently training a therapy dog. Photography. Well, that one landed squarely on me. Special thanks to Mike for scanning thousands of photos, and Julia and Becca for helping me to assemble and edit this show. Flowering dogwoods, morel mushrooms, colorful flowers, calling loons, breathtaking scenery, white birch trees, crunchy fall leaves and laughing children, red cardinals, hooty owls, cozy fires, and down quilts comforters, furry collies, and of course, tasty ice cream will remind you of Pat. Her loving heart will always live inside those that she touched.
Here's a card from Cindy. Happy Mother's Day to someone very special. Dear Pat, more than you know, you make a difference in this world. More than you know, you spread smiles and laughter. More than you know, you inspire with your kindness. That's why, more than you know, you deserve a very special Mother's Day. I love you, Pat. From Cindy. Mom, I'll always love you. I can't remember a time that I didn't need your love and support, and I can't imagine a time when I won't. I love you, and I always will. Happy Mother's Day. Dear Mom, Grandma, and Great Grandma, you keep stacking up the titles. Such a professional now, smiley face. In 1 week, I finally get to experience a trip to Alaska. Richard, Rebecca, Jonathan, and I are taking a cruise ship up the Inside Passage and then a week to explore Anchorage and Denali. I am so excited. Darla, let me know of any must-sees. I am so happy for all the places you and Dad took us to see the beloved camper every summer. You made great travelers out of us with a love for mountains, smiley face. After that, I get to remind people at the pool where I teach swimming that I am still around until I fly to take care of Tasha's little ones for a couple of weeks. Then a few short days in the canoe boundary water wilderness area. At the end of August, Anna and her boys and I and Tasha will come to see you, and I can't wait. I love you more than there are buds on the trees in the whole northern hemisphere. Love you, Donna. Aw, thank you, Donna. We love you. Grandma, you're the heart of our family. Dear Grandma, happy Mother's Day. Every time I think of what a good mother should be, you always come to mind. Even as I move to Chicago, I find myself using phrases and words that you taught me over the years. The words, you catch more bees with honey, phrase has especially helped me when dealing with particularly hard to talk to professors. I think it has also been helping as I came into finals week. I just wanted to say that I value the lessons you taught me and the investment you made to influence how I see the world today. You literally are the best grandma in the whole entire world. And I love you, Julia. And the card says, you've got great stories to share, a lifetime of wisdom to offer, and lots of people who love you. I know, Grandma, because I am one of them. Happy Mother's Day.
I love you, Mom. I love you all day because you're inside me. You live inside me. When I'm playing with the grandkids, clean up the kitchen, smelling the flowers with the boys, the little boys. Yep. You're going to weep with me, inside me, the whole way. Thanks, Mom.
To know Mom is to know me. So when you wonder why I take thousands of photographs, which you are about to experience, have 50 houseplants with a garage full of wintering annuals, have thousands of books, though I hear my siblings have exponentially more, have 3 gallons of ice cream in my freezer at all times, seek water to swim and to play, have 9 canoes and 5 kayaks, I give great back rubs, and I have curly hair and a great figure, all from Mom. I love soft animals for fur therapy and companionship. I bake banana bread to give away and visit aging friends. I fill my chocolate chip cookies with nuts and oatmeal. If you wonder why I spent 10 summers at Sycamore Valley Girl Scout Camp and have t-shirts from all 10 years still and might have a little bit of a hoarding issue, why I save extra food from a restaurant in a napkin, why I went to Purdue and met a husband, why I love to be outside, especially hiking and camping, why I became a Cub Scout den mother, why I married an Eagle Scout and raised 2 boys to become Eagle Scouts, why I formed Venture Crew 007, why I am transported by music and I love performing arts, why I had lots of kids so they will have lots of kids, why I stayed close to home to do life together, why I provide practical meals and hospitality, why my freezer and cabinets are always too full, why I frequently have house guests. The bed count is up to 21 right now, with fluffy comforters and wool blankets. Why I plant trees, why I climb trees, why I wanted a house with a fireplace and big picture windows and a yard full of bikes and a sandbox and a jungle gym and tree swings. Why I like to go sledding and build snowmen and make snow ice cream. Why I can make any gadget or costume. You may wonder why I prefer to be outside and might have been known to take my shirt off for sunbathing. Why I'm an artist. Why I have multitudes of toys, all the classics. Why I have hundreds of children's books, old and new, and I am the book reader. Why I have too many stuffed animals to count. Why I'm an animal lover. Why I shop at secondhand stores. Why I go and help my children paint their houses. Why I plant flowers to bloom 3 seasons. The gardening and the canning gene is best left to the siblings, but I do have strawberries, raspberries, asparagus, mint, sage, and I make maple syrup. Why I taught Sunday school and held babies in the church nursery. How I spend my time and my money helping family members and friends. Her sweet, gentle spirit? Well, not so much. God is still working on me for that. When you wonder why I'm a Christ follower, it's because Mom took me to church where I met Jesus and set a wonderful example for me for loving well. And I truly look forward to painting birds and flowers and sunsets, probably not sunrises, in heaven with Mom one of these days.
Baby, all I got is this beat up leather bag. Everything I own don't fill up half. But don't you worry about the way I pack. All I care about is getting back real soon. Goodbye kiss is all I need. Carrying your love with me, Indiana up to Lake Birdie. I'll be moving with the good Lord's speed. Carrying your love with me, it's my strength for holding on. Every minute that I have to be gone, I'll have everything I'll ever need. Carrying your love with me. On a lonely highway, stuck out in the rain. Darling, all I have to do is speak your name. The clouds roll back and the waters part. The sun starts shining in my heart for you. You're right there in everything. Indiana up to Lake Birdie. I'll be moving with the good Lord's speed. Carrying your love with me, it's my strength for holding on. Every minute that I have to be gone, I'll have everything I'll ever need. Carrying your love with me.
Who I am. towards you and kiss your peace. Suddenly I'm lost.
When I die. hallelujah by and by.
While the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ears, the Son of God discloses, and He walks with me, and He talks with me. And he tells me I am his own. And the voice I hear falling on my ear, no other has ever known.
Hey!
Let me
see. I don't know, because you sing. You say, and the voice I hear falling in my ear, the song that God has closed. Okay, just a minute. Let me, well, just a minute. Let me, let's play it. Just a minute.
When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away. I'll fly away.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. And I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Thank you.
Love you, Mom.
Love you.
Love you.
I love you, Mom.
I love you, Mom. I will miss you very much. Bye-bye.
I love you, Grandma.
We love you so much, Grandma. Thank you for everything.
We love you, Grandma!
That's good. Cece, you do it just right.
I love you, Grandma!
I love you, Grandma!
We love you, Grandma!
I love you, Mom.
I love you, Pat.
We love you, Grandma.
Hi, Grandma. We love you.
We love you, Grandma.
We love you, Grandma Pat.
We love you so much, Grandma.
I love you, Pat. Te amo.
We love you, Mom.
I love you too.